economy. Nigerians are growing, and in a long time, this is the first time Nigeria will be slipping into economic recession. What can we have from you as
I think that people are, my memories are short. When I was military head of state, we had a bad situation. People have forgotten that. The situation was so bad that I have to look at a list of things to ban. Many things that I decided must be banned. We tried price control. It did not work. Now, when I came back as elected president, the position, oil position, the price of oil was very, people have forgotten that. It hovered between $8 and $9 when I came in. And in fact, we couldn't budget, balance our budget. But economy is going up and down. Now, where we have behaved stupidly is that we do not bear in mind that there will be a rainy day. Now, when I work for that, I believe in that. That was why I said, look, first of all, let me get debt relief. Because we were spending almost $3 billion to service debt. And yet the quantum of our debt was not going down. Now, if we can save that, that was substantial. And we did. All right? Let us also, in the past, what we used to do is, before I became president, what we used to do is we budget, and any money that was realized above the price we budget for the that we would sell oil, we spend it. I said, no, that's not the way to go. Keep it for a rainy day. And we created what we call excess crude, for lack of a better word. Now, when I was president, the governors will come to me and say, look, let's share this money. After all, it belongs to all of us. That is excess crude. And I refused. I said, the training we must save for the rainy day. They said, the rains have come. The rains are here. But there was no rain then. And when the rains came, they have squandered the money. And that's why we are where we are now.
So what do you think about the current revenue sharing formula? What do you think needs to be done?
Already, we have too high overhead. Whether it's at the state level or at the federal level or at local government level, to the extent that we don't have money for capital. I think the highest that we have had is about 30%. Now, we should be spending nothing less than 60% of our revenue on capital development.
Okay, let's come back to more personal issues now, because this is your 80th birthday and nothing is going to take away that fun. But one project you hold dearly is the Presidential Library. Could you tell us more about this?
Well, as I've had occasion to explain to people, I've had a number of events in my life that about 1988, I looked back and I saw that I had been negligent in looking at materials, in keeping records and all that. One was the Civil War. At the end of the Civil War, we collected some things from the Biafran side, and we had some of our own. By the time I look at those things later, they are already damaged. I managed to salvage some by microfilming them and all that. Then I was in the military government, and I was head of a military government, again, the same happened. So, about 1988, I said to myself, well, let's see what can be salvaged. And as I said, we did. But I learned a lesson. But I never knew that there would be a second opportunity or a second chance. So when God, who is God of many opportunities or many chances, gave me a second opportunity or a second chance, the lesson I've learned, I put it.
Before we wind down this conversation now, we really want to get down to know the phenomenon Olusegun Obasanjo. I have to open up to you. A lot of Nigerians have described you in different ways. Some have called you a man after God's own heart. Some have described you as a very lucky person. Some even feel that you have a magical charm. They call you a Bora Owu because you always come out at the lucky side of things. People feel that nature has been so kind to you.
Yeah, you haven't finished. Some feel that I'm dubious. But all that you said, there's no human being that is either perfect or is a bundle of one thing. I give you a true story. When I was military, when I was president, four of my children got their heads together. And I was looking at them. One of them was a psychologist. I said, what are you doing? They said they are trying to psychoanalyze me. Oh, well, I thought that was interesting. So I left them. After about 3 hours, I saw them going in their different ways. So I called them. I said, hey, what is the result of your analysis? They said, Daddy, you are more complex than we thought. And so if anybody want to straight jacket me and say, Obasanjo is this, I think he will be wrong. Now, I'm a bit of all that you have said. I'm lucky, and I count myself lucky. Not too long ago, I even put it more blatantly. I said, God has been partial to me in blessing me more than I deserve, in giving me favor beyond what I should have had. I said, being born in this village like this, nobody should have heard my name beyond the next village. God made it up. So if you say I'm lucky, yes, I am. But the point is that I stand for something. And what I stand for, I always stand for. I stand for Nigeria.
I'm sure as you mark your 80th birthday, I'm sure one major thing that will bring your mind is the nation Nigeria, because you talked about providence, and it's as if providence really gave you this country to midwife. Would you say this is the Nigeria of a dream?
I have dream and vision of a great country. Now the fact that Nigeria remains a united country is part of my dream. Now that Nigeria has not reached the level of prosperity, the level of greatness that I would want it to be, is part of my dream, not yet realized. But I will be a fool to lose hope. I always say I have hope. I have hope that Nigeria will be great.
Former President Olusegun Obasanjo, thank you so much for making our time to be part of this episode of Question Time. And we also wish you, as you mark your 80th birthday, we wish you a more glorious year in sound health and prosperity. Thank you very much indeed.
Gwenga, thank you very much. You are welcome any day. But now that you have broken the ice, maybe we'll see more of you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.